Tuesday, May 1st, 2018, Monaco 64, home of alternative economics and contrarian views. I've decided to make a few more videos. This is going to be a short one. It's a warning about a market move that I'm seeing in the British pound or sterling. And I'm going to look at the technical picture, talk a little bit about the fundamentals as well. And it is not advice for people to trade on. It's just what I'm seeing. And so let's go. Let's start. British pound. Fundamentally, of course, we had some data recently. GDP data last week for the first quarter. Very weak. Looks like the UK economy is grounding to a halt again. I've spoken about how GDP is even weaker than people perceive it to be, mainly because it's been driven by government spending and huge budget deficits that the governments have been running for the last 10 years. Today, we also had another economic data. It was lower than expected. I think it was the PMI. The pound has dropped again. It's down 0.2%. It's down at 136.73. So I think we are at a critical juncture for the pound in the medium term. I'm going to look at a weekly chart and show you why I think that is so. And so here we go. This is from barchart.com. Got a weekly chart going back to end of 2015. You can see that since October of 2016, we've been in an upward trend. We had a big drop after the Brexit vote, of course. It went from just below 150. And we had like a flash crash in the pound, I think, in Asia sometime in October of 2016. We got down to like 117.10 against the dollar. And as you can see, we've been in an upward trend channel in the pound. And recently we got up to a high of 143.76. That was in the middle of April. Earlier towards the end of January, we got up to 143.45. So we've actually formed what is called a double top. Aside from also forming like a channel, we formed this double top. The midpoint of the double top, that's towards the end of February when we went down to 137.12. So we've broken through that level, 137.12, just this week. As I speak here, we are at 136.74. So is the pound going to hold this trend line that we've been seeing since October 2016, this upward trend, or are we going to break through this trend line? The trend line right now, this for this week, comes in at around here, really, maybe a little lower, just above 136. So I would say if we close the week below 136, that will not bode well for the pound technically. And we will also have closed below the midpoint of that double top, which is around 137.12. So if you go 137.12 or 143.60 minus 137.12, that's about six big figures. So you extrapolate 137 minus six big figures, we've got a target of 131 in the pound against the dollar. When would that happen if we break through that trend line and we continue lower? It's always difficult to know, but don't forget this is a weekly chart. So it's not going to be in a matter of hours or days. Maybe it'll be weeks, maybe a month. We could go to 131. And it would be quite significant, in my opinion, if we break below this trend line. That means that the correction higher that we've had since October 2016 is finished, and that the pound is going to go down again. And eventually even retest 120 and even that flash crash low of around 117. So not looking good. But it's interesting that this week on Thursday we have local elections in the UK, May 3rd on Thursday. And that could be something that could influence the currency, especially if the Labour Party do very well in the local elections. So I think that's what's happening right now. So key juncture for the pound here. Will it hold this trend line? Will it break it? We'll have to wait and see. But I think we're very close to finding out. I guess trading wise, this is what I would do. I'm not advising people to do. You can take it either way. You could buy it if it touches that line and put a tight stop, or you could sell it. I personally would rather be short the pound right now. I think I would be selling it on rallies. I think we're going to break that trend line. I think the cat is out of the bag, so to speak. The economy is weakening, and things are not great for the UK economy. And I think, they probably want to see a weaker pound, because they can't really raise rates right now. The UK economy is dependent on very low rates. It's dependent on credit and the housing market. Basically, it's a consumption-driven, financial sector-driven, credit-driven economy. It's been hollowed out. There's no more manufacturing or exports. So they need to keep things going. And that's it. So if you enjoyed this video, please like, share it, subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. And you can also follow me on steemit.com and DTube and on Twitter. And I'll talk to you later. Take care.